Hello everyone, I'm Philip, and today we're going to be going through setting up local settings sync. First off though, why do you need this and why would you need this? I'll show you a use case that I have currently. As you can see here, I have a brand new Gitpod account with no preferences, nothing set up. I'll go ahead and select an editor, which is VS Code in the browser. Now I'll just create a workspace and I'll go ahead and do something like template TypeScript node. All right, so a workspace opened, and as you can see, everything's the way that Gitpod is usually. But what I don't like about it is my local VS Code, which I have used for the past few years, is full of preferences, full of themes and settings and extensions, which I don't have here. It looks completely different from my local setup, which I have right here. As you can see, nice icons and a different color theme. There's some order to these icons in the side menu. The sidebar is on the right, not on the left. I have many extensions, which I necessarily don't want to manually install all in Gitpod. That is something that a thing called Settings Sync can help with. All right, so how do you set up Settings Sync? It's actually pretty simple. The thing you do here is that you go to your local VS Code and you search for the Gitpod extensions. In the extensions view, you find the extension. If it's not installed, it just say install and we have it already. You will have this already if you, for example, used the VS Code desktop integration with Gitpod, and that automatically installs it in order to tunnel to your Gitpod workspace. Now, what we need to do is open the command palette. You can do this by doing command or control shift P or hitting the F1 key on your keyboard. This pops up and now just start typing settings sync and this should pop up. There should be different options here, but I see here that the one we want, it's enable sign in with Gitpod. What this does is it replaces our configuration of VS Code so that our VS Code locally doesn't use GitHub or Microsoft as the authentication provider. It did do that until now. I have Settings Sync with GitHub right now enabled. As you can see here, Philip, try and check GitHub, and that's what my Settings Sync is currently at. But now it will be replaced by Gitpod's configuration. So Gitpod values a Gitpod server which the preferences will be stored in. If you turn off the GitHub or Microsoft Settings Sync, nothing will be lost. You'll just migrate over to another data store. So we'll do the command. We'll just hit enter when we have it highlighted. And there's a notification saying that we need to quit VS Code for the new Settings Sync configuration to take effect. I recommend just hard stopping or forcefully killing VS Code here, because it needs to restart all over to take in the configuration we just added. So I'll do quit, and there's no more VS Code. We'll restart it, and here we go. Not a lot of things changed. The thing that did though is that we're still signed into GitHub and Settings Sync, but there's a new thing that's saying sign into Settings Sync. This was not here before, because before, GitHub was the authentication provider for Settings Sync that we had. This is now sign in to, this just shows sign in to Settings Sync now. We'll hit that and it should open our browser and it should open this window right here. It says authorize VS Code Gitpod extension. This just is like an OAuth pop-up that we need to authorize this app. We'll hit authorize and this will prompt to open Visual Studio Code. We'll open it and we'll let VS Code open this URI as well. So we opened it and Settings Sync is on, as you can see right here. That's all good and great. This should be reflected here in the Settings Sync output. We can see that all of our preferences, settings, and themes have been synced already, which was pretty fast. So what we can do now is take a look at VS Code in the browser again to see if we have the extensions and themes. So we'll go right back to the Gitpod workspace. We'll go to our dashboard and we can either stop the workspace and restart it basically, or we can just create a new one because we haven't made any changes there. So I think that's probably better for the demo right here. All right. And now we should start seeing our preferences be displayed to us. As you can see already, the sidebar is the right, which is correct, and that's what we want. All of the extensions are currently downloading. As you can see, there's 73 extensions, which weren't there before. There was zero extensions before. So it looks like setting sync works. And of course, this does not just apply to one-time migrations from desktop to VS Code Web. So you can use VS Code Web, download an extension there, and it will be reflected in some short period of time that VS Code checks every couple minutes to see if there are any changes. So it will check for new extensions. If it finds it, then it will download it on your desktop machine. All right, so this has been local setting sync. If you have any questions or have any feedback, because it's fairly new and we released this quite recently, feel free to reach out on our community platforms. You can access via gitpod.io/chat, and I'll see you all next time.